president to be here, to be the eyes and the ears of what happens as and when that comes in. Yesterday, Florida, we asked a question, why is it so slow to update?
Yes.
Because after Justice Byabakama reads, it takes us like 5 to 10 minutes for the website to be updated. So what we do, part of our job is to write whatever he has said in his provisional declaration and we compare with what the platform is saying. And that's why we're saying that it was quite very slow, because what we wanted is that just we already have it on the platform. But yesterday he said the slowness of these figures coming on the platform is intended. They want to double check, verify, double check, and then upload.
Andrew Chamagaro, I'm asking in regards to you who's on the ground and able to access this, whether slow or not. Is this inhibiting the flow of information, especially for the media? Because we always like to know as quickly as possible and as fast as possible. Is it causing many questions on the ground from you and the team?
Well, from where we stand, it doesn't cause questions, because we can see the system. This system is very simple, that if someone has updated something from Koboko, you'll get an alarm. You'll get to know that, this has happened. Koboko has updated, and you're going to see the figures. So by the time he comes to tell you that, look, this is how much you have, at least you have some figures already in the vicinity. You can know that, okay, this was added on, this came through, this came through. However, what we wanted earlier on, and our question was, can we know how many people voted in Kiruhura, for example? If we show that Kiruhura has 200 polling stations, we need to know, yes, we have seen 11 polling stations have come in with regards to the data, but how many of those in the register went and voted? Like, we wanted the breakdown of districts by district, but the chairperson said that is so much difficulty, which we can find later, they'll give us that report a little later, but for now they are focusing on the valid vote.
Is this inhibiting the
flow of focusing on the invalid votes. They are focusing on the total ballot counting and the declared polling stations. And that is one way or the other, as people have elected directly elected MPs. So one would ask the question and say that in Moko South constituency, so and so seems to be the winner. So the software will show me that in Moko South, have a 400 polling station, but from the 400 polling stations, from the 100 polling stations we have, Flavia is leading by this percentage.
Yes.
So it will show you that Flavia currently is the leading one. Now on the interface, it will show you that that's the winner, but not declared yet. So until when all these polling stations have been tallied, that's when we can be in position to say that in a division A or in a municipality or constituency B, so and so is the winner. And that's why we are not at liberty, the ones at the polling at the National Tally Center, to tell you that so and so is the winner of the MP seat of this district.
Wow, actually, because somebody had asked a question on our SMS line and say, are we able to even know the percentage so far of, say, this candidate is doing this well in this region, central or eastern? And from what I'm getting from you, the answer is a no.
It's a no, because they will tell you from this constituency, there are 7 people vying for the position. Now, from those vying for the position, it is Flavia Tumusime leading. Now, the one leading is the one the interface shows us.
Wow.
It will tell us that Flavia is leading by 42.5% with this much vote. Remember, there are 6. And remember, there are only 11 polling stations of the 200 that have already come through. So we are still waiting for the others to come through. As and when they come, the system keeps updating. However, when we get to 4 p.m. today, whoever will be in the system as the winner at the time, according to the Electoral Commission, they say that will be the winner.
Right.
Because they will have tallied a lot of polling stations, and what will be in the software, that will be the match content and data they have to say that to the person, then they will close it.
Right. Okay, I understand that. Two things. You said noon would be the time they'd be able to announce for us possibly the final results, and that would be all including the presidential election. So perhaps I know most of the questions that are coming in is, why are they keeping us in the dark? Why are they keeping us in the dark? But do you believe that what you've said, oh, it's easy for us to see, it's easy for us to know, do you believe that this technical way of doing things has smoothened the way of you getting information at the tally center, has made things, if at all, much easier for the media, and also to perhaps the mood, because we're blind to see what's happening there at the official tally center. The mood before noon, is everybody anticipating, have the candidates and their agents, what's happening before noon?
Well, when someone says that they are blinded to what is happening, I think it depends on the context. Because we as NTV, we have kept the world abreast with the information as and when it comes in. We have live cameras and video coverages that are coming streaming from here. Whenever the chairperson is talking, we get the information. Whatever happens, I'm in touch, and you're in touch with me and the other reporters who are going to give the update. So I think what happens here is, the security level where the internet was shut down and a software or another platform was secured to give us the information. Yet they say that by noon we should be in position to know who is the president of this country, because they said, according to the tallies they have, they said if they have at least 80% or 75% of polling stations registered and tallied through, then by noon they can announce who the winner is.
Yes.
But by law, they have to go up to 4 p.m. So if they do it at noon, the earlier the better for them. But if they feel that more data is coming in and they need to actually look through it, verify it, and then send it to the media, then that takes them up to 4 p.m. So the anxiousness at the National Tallying Center is from a few agents I've seen around. They just can't be so sure. They're like, if they mention at noon what's going to happen, those are questions they were asking. They thought if they announced during day, possibly it could bring some little bit of unrest. But again, the UPDF and the police spokesperson yesterday made it adequate. They said Ugandans went and voted. They were very peaceful in this practice. So they strongly believe it's the same practice they're going to carry all the way through. So the declaration, I think, Flavia, it is just unfair for someone to say where they holding us to noon or to 4 p.m.
Yeah.
Previously, the presidency has always been announced late in the night. So I think from where I stand, it's better that you go to sleep when you know who is the president. You're not so much on tension, or you're not anxious. Your nerves are relaxed. You know, okay, this is what happens then. The other avenues can take it up. But information is coming in, and we have very critical observers who are watching. And not only that, they give us very clear districts who is